Ms. Gupta, why do you wish to join the civil service?
Oh, so actually while I was in college in my fourth year, so I was working on some project called navigation for visually impaired people. And during that project, I realized that despite I using my computer skills over there, there were many other challenges. For example, the affordability or the accessibility or the ability to read and understand such mobile applications. And I think it was at that moment that I realized that I wanted to cater to the wider scope of the problems. And I thought civil services offered me a way to do so.
So what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
So first, I think civil servant must have a leadership qualities. So this would be the one. The second would be...
What are those qualities, leadership qualities?
In the leadership, sir? So the first would be to take everybody along with you, despite having some maybe divergence in the group. So you come at a the medium path, or you somehow come at a consensus. So that would be the first thing. The second would be to address each and everyone's grievances in that group, and so that no one feels alienated from the group and everybody gives their best potential in that work.
If you are in the police.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you are looking for a consensus and addressing everyone's grievance, nothing will get done.
Yes, sir.
Hmm? Half the fellows don't want to work on holidays.
Yes, sir.
They like to go home. But you have a duty to perform.
Yes, sir.
You have to do policing. When others are enjoying, you have to do policing.
Yes, sir.
So if you're seeking consensus, or even as a DM, there's a flood.
Yes, sir.
There's an earthquake.
Yes, sir.
And if you're seeking consensus, then you will only go on seeking consensus and you will not be able to achieve anything.
Yes, sir.
So consensus is not a quality which is of such a great importance here. Think of something else, basic.
Yes, sir. So if I may add over here, as you also said, my first thing would also be to do something which they can consider as a role model. For example, as you gave the example, that first of all, I am letting go of my holidays. I am participating in that flooded state and I am giving my best over there. So I think that will be also one of the things that they will see up to.
Ms. Gupta,
yes,
have you heard of this Right to Information Act?
Yes.
What are the salient features of this act?
Yes, sir. Right to Information Act gives the basic right to information to each and every citizen of India. It provides that if you want to access some information, which definitely there are some restrictions also, so if that information does not fall in that, you can access that within a given time limit. And if the information is not provided to you, then you also have some appeal mechanisms for the same.
What are the appeal mechanisms?
Yes, sir. So, for example, there is now started online mechanism also. And then you can also submit your application at the office also.
But the purpose of the act was to bring about greater transparency,
yes,
and openness in the government functioning.
Yes, sir.
Do you think that this has been achieved by this act?
So, to a large extent, yes. Because people are accessing it for very good information.
Mm-hmm.
For example, I accessed it to know about what is the strength of girls at IIT Delhi. And I think it's a very useful insight for a person like me.
Did you get a response?
So I do get a response, but I was also told that there are, because at the time there was ongoing proposals on reservation for women at IIT Delhi. So I was told that some of the information is restricted and you won't be able to access it.
So did you file an appeal on that or not?
No, sir. So because I thought that it is a genuine restriction, because the proposal was ongoing, so I shouldn't be asking that information, which is critical at this point of the time.
Now, what are are there any exemptions given to certain organizations under the Right to Information Act?
So I feel yes. For example, the organizations that are concerned with the national security, for example, Intelligence Bureau, for example, National Investigating Agency. So a common citizen cannot, I would say, access that information, which is very critical for the...
Let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
Some time back, an RTI was filed with the CBI seeking to know the amount of money which the organization has spent.
Yes, sir.
On their efforts to extradite Vijay Mallya.
Okay, sir.
And this was refused.
Okay, sir.
By the CBI.
Okay,
you think that was a correct decision? Or should this information have been given?
So according to me, though I'm not aware of this news information, but based on what you tell me, I think there might be reasons given why this information was not given, and if we can judge that those reasons were good enough, then I can, yes, there can be some restrictions.
Okay, right. Now, let's come to something else.
Yes.
You know, this Lokpal issue has been pending for a very long time.
Yes, sir.
What exactly would be the constitution of the Lokpal?
Sir, Lokpal would consist of, first of all, the Prime Minister of India.
Yeah.
The second would be the Leader of Opposition.
Yes.
I'm not able to recall it.
Speaker,
yes, sir.
And then?
Then I think Chief Justice of India.
Very true.
And
an eminent jurist.
Eminent jurist.
So has that been done yet? Has
no,
any
sir.
Progress been made or not?
No, sir. So because 2014 Lok Sabha, there is an issue about the Leader of Opposition place because that does not qualify under the 10% criteria. So that is why Lokpal has not been constituted yet.
Okay. But the Supreme Court had asked the government as to what is the progress.
Yes, sir.
And the government has been inviting the Leader of the Opposition.
Yes, sir.
But he has not been attending those meetings.
Okay, sir.
Hmm?
Sir, I'm sorry, I'm not aware of
it. You're not aware?
Yes.
Okay, right. Now, there's a dispute going on between China and Canada at the moment over the arrest of and detention of a member. Are you aware of that?
Sir, I think I know some details, but I'm not sure about
well, what exactly do you know about?
Sir, that one of the member, person of, I think China was arrested in Canada. I'm not sure,
yeah,
sir.
You check up on that because
sure,
this
sir.
Is a very major diplomatic row which is building up.
Yes, sir.
Because the girl who has been arrested is the chief financial officer of Hawaii,
okay,
and the daughter of the owner of the Hawaii industries,
okay,
right? And Canada is holding her on behalf of the US where she is to be extradited.
Okay,
right?
Okay.
Now, are we also trying to extradite somebody?
Yes, sir.
From the US?
Yes.
From the US.
From the UK, sir, I know Mr. Vijay Mallya.
That is Vijay Mallya.
Yes,
that his case is pending in the court. He's filed an appeal there, right?
Yes, sir.
There is a person whom we are seeking now from the US. Have you heard of a person called Tahavur Rana?
No, sir, I'm not aware of
him. Right. What do you feel about the Sabarimala issue, the decision made by the Supreme Court? Because it's led to a lot of controversy in the state also. What is your view?
Yes, sir. So I think my view is that the decision that was taken by the Supreme Court is a very progressive view, and it actually puts women's right at front with the men's right. So in that context, this is definitely a very right step.
Okay, thank you.
Ms. Gupta.
Yes.
You are involved with a national service scheme, right?
Yes, sir.
In what capacity?
Sir, when you enter IIT Delhi, you have to complete certain credits either in NSS, NSO or NCC.
What is the basic motto behind creation of NSS?
So the motto of NSS says that be the change you wish to see in the world. So it is meant to do the social service, for example, teaching slum children, teaching people at National Association of Blind, cleanliness drives, cloth collection drives. It has also a partnership with NGOs like Goonj, Aina, which help other people.
Okay. You are also playing badminton?
Yes.
Badminton has come of age in India?
I'm sorry, sir.
Will you agree if I say that badminton has come of age in India? It has achieved certain degree of success?
Yes, sir. Especially in the recent times, I would definitely agree to your statement.
And how do you say that?
Sir, because recently our players like Saina Nehwal, PV Sindhu or Sameer Verma has won many medals and they are excelling at this field.
What has contributed to this increased participation of the general population in badminton?
Yes, sir. So the first is the availability of training. For example, in Bangalore, the training center that is opened by Pulila Gopichand is very famous, and it actually the Saina Nehwal, PV Sindhu are actually product of that training center.
Corporate funding has also come?
Yes, sir. So many corporates are involved in the promoting badminton.
Okay, now a different question.
Yes.
You have heard of subsidy targeting?
Subsidy targeting.
Has any effort been made by the government to target subsidies, delivery of subsidies?
Yes, sir. So, for example, direct benefit transfer is a step in which we are targeting subsidies.
And which particular subsidy has been targeted?
So, for example, sir, give me a few moments.
Sure.
Yes, sir. So the Pehel scheme, which is meant for LPG subsidies, so it is provided under DBT nowadays.
Are there any attempt to include more subsidies in in the group of targeting?
Yes, sir. So Enginarega is also being provided through DBT, but I believe
Enginarega is not a subsidy.
Sir, I'm sorry for using the word subsidy. I mean the wages that are provided under Enginarega are provided through DBT.
Now, what are the main subsidies given by the central government?
Yes, sir. So there are fertilizer subsidies that are given to the farmers.
Mm-hmm.
Then there are subsidies in the term of the food that food products that are given at PDS ration shops.
As far as fertilizer is concerned,
yes,
any attempt made by the government to target?
Sir, yes, sir. So basically, fertilizer subsidies nowadays are provided to the fertilizer companies directly rather than the farmers. This is done to somehow restrict the divergence of the fertilizers.
Last question.
Yes, sir.
Your second and third preference, you have given income tax and cost of income tax.
Yes, sir.
Now, post GST.
Yes, sir.
Has the role of income tax service and also the customs and general excise undergone any change?
Sir, I think definitely with the economic reforms coming into the country, these services are also witnessing those reforms. These services have a very large hand in handling those reforms and ensuring that these reforms reach each and every individual of the country.
What has been the trend of direct tax and indirect tax collection in the current year?
Sir, the percentage wise?
No, what has been the trend
okay,
growth?
Okay, sir. So the direct taxes as well as the indirect taxes has been on the rise in the country.
But are there any shortfalls over what was envisaged in the budget?
Sir, recently there was a shortfall in the GST collection as it was envisaged in the budget.
Okay, thank you.
You were given an award regarding research.
Yes,
what was your research about?
Ma'am, my research was on finding chords of a given song. So there was an application about it, but I have to improve its efficiency using the probabilistic graphical models.
So were you able to prove something?
Yes, ma'am. I have improved efficiency from 30% to 79%.
Okay. And you also practice meditation?
Yes, ma'am.
So how do you do it? Do you say a mantra or what do you do?
Ma'am, my form of meditation is mindfulness meditation.
What does it mean?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in this meditation, I focus on my breath for 10 to 15 minutes. So, in case any irrational thoughts are coming in without any judgment, I try to do away with them and focus on my breath again.
So, you learnt it on your own or you asked some teacher to teach you?
Ma'am, actually, there's a funny story about it. One of my teachers started this practice of teaching us meditation to keep the students silent. So, for the first 10 minutes of the class, there is a very hustle in the class.
Okay, I get it. Also, you've written teaching is a hobby or an area of interest.
Yes, ma'am.
So, who did you teach?
Ma'am, I have taught, I'm teaching since my 9th class. So, at that time, I taught my neighbor students and my helper students, helpers children. At IIT Delhi, I taught people like National Association of Blind and also the slum children.
And are you aware of what is known as contractual teaching?
Ma'am, are you talking about the teachers?
Delhi University, they are talking about contractual teaching.
Ma'am,
giving
sorry.
A contract to teachers for 1 year at a time. Have you heard about that
scheme? I'm sorry, ma'am, I'm not aware of in this context.
Alright, never mind. Now, you've also been interested in trending this trend.
Yes, ma'am.
You've heard about the Swachh Bharat program.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me something about it.
Ma'am, it's a pan-India campaign that was started, that was focused on sanitation, hygiene, cleanliness in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And also with the cleaning of rivers, also handling the open defecation in the country. And also it has actually widened its scope also. For example, doing away with the corruption has also been now thought that it is a part.
You talked of cleaning of the rivers.
Yes, ma'am.
So how are the rivers going to be cleaned under this Swachh Bharat plan?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the first step I think is to ensure that there is no extra waste that is now put into the rivers, for example the industry.
So what will they do? How will they do it?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I think the onus should be on the industries in that case that they ensure a waste disposal systems, especially with the technologies coming in. I think there is a definitely an area where you can convert that waste into either a useful thing like energy or there is a proper way to dispose that
so
waste.
So STPs are required? Basically, sewage treatment plants.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. What else?
Ma'am, second is the developing the culture of sanitation among the common public because most of the times they are also involved in throwing their waste at the rivers. The third I would say is cleaning the current rivers, whatever the waste or BOD levels is present at that rivers. So we do have some technologies.
So how successful has this program been from the day of implementation?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it has been around like 4 years since mm-hmm. this scheme. I would say definitely there has been some progress. We all have incorporated it in our behavioral aspects also to some level. But I would also say there is a lot more to do.
Do you think there's a change in attitude?
Ma'am, I think there is, because it feels a new kind of energy in you when you hear Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. You actually focus on that.
You are from Delhi.
Ma'am, I stayed.
You are from Punjab, but you are working in Delhi, or you studied in Delhi?
Ma'am, I studied in IIT Delhi, and that is when I stayed in Delhi. Okay.
So you are from Punjab.
Yes.
Suppose you became an administrator in Barnala.
Yes, ma'am.
What issues would you address first of all? Give me two main issues which you would like to address.
Ma'am, the first issue that I address is the employment in the women, because the ratio in, especially because it's a very small district, is 1:6 people who are working. Only one is the female.
What type of jobs are there?
Ma'am, the only industry in Barnala is the Trident group of industries. So my focus will also be to ensure that more industries come into the town. And also, especially since the nearby areas of Barnala are agriculture dominating areas. So ensuring there are well-to-do jobs available in that sector with the help of elite sectors like poultry, animal husbandry, etc.
Now my last question related to your field, that is computer science.
Yes,
ma'am. 1 year of big data. What is big data?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, big data is basically defined by 3 V's, the volume, variety and velocity. So when you get a large amount of data, which has a huge variety in it, and it comes with a huge speed to you, then it's termed as a big data.
What are the advantages?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I would give an example here. For example, Google, when we search something, it is accessing all our searches. It is checking what we searched, when we searched, where are we located. So it is all a big data to Google. So next time when we search something, there are some recommendations coming in. So we are at ease as a consumer, and Google, using that big data, is ensuring that we get proper customer services.
Alright, thank you.
Thank you.
Can you tell us what are these fundamental duties? Are they enforceable? Can you recall some of the duties?
Yes, sir. So fundamental duties are not enforceable under any law, but some of the fundamental duties are, first of all, I would say to preserve the heritage of India in the terms of monuments. The second would be to respect the national flag, national anthem and the constitution of India. The third would be parents' duty to send their children of age 6 to 14 years to schools. The fourth would be the animal milk.
Yeah. There is one duty to develop scientific temper.
Yes, sir.
What is scientific temper and how does that help?
Yes, sir. So I believe there are certain values that are associated with scientific temper. For example, objectivity, rationality, using logic. So scientific temperament in general is developed when you reach science subjects like be it mathematics, physics, chemistry, medical science. In general, it is developed in that way in the formal education system. However, there are also ways in which you can develop that in informal education system also.
But those with arts background, they do not have scientific temper?
Definitely, sir, they do. I'm sorry, I missed that point. Social studies science is also a kind of a science.
Okay. There was a spurt in this Me Too movement.
Yes,
why do you think it came up all of a sudden? Was there a gap in law, vacuum in law? And why did people take to the social media rather than taking to legal recourse?
Yes, sir. So I think I will agree to you here that though the movement started with the very right intentions of showing how in depth the problem of sexual harassment is, however, it is actually a spillout of the lack of our legal systems, because I believe social media is not a correct platform for the women to represent their grievances as well as for the institutions to hear their grievances. So I feel, as you said, that Me Too is a result of a lack of our legal systems.
Is there any institutional mechanism to deal with sexual harassment at workplaces?
Yes, sir. So there is a Sexual Harassment at Workplaces Act, in which internal complaints committee, she box also are created where women can complain about it and ensure that the grievances are heard.
Okay. There was a Supreme Court judgment on triple talaq. Are you aware of that?
Yes.
What was the judgment?
Yes, sir. So the Shaira Banu judgment that you're talking about talks about that the triple talaq, which is given to especially to Muslim women, is actually against their own rights. it marginalizes them. It is basically a question on their rights.
What was the finding on triple talaq?
So it was found that triple talaq is not an essential practice under the religion of Islam, and thus it cannot be classified that so it can be abolished as it encroaches upon rights of the woman.
Did they recommend abolition or they abolished it altogether?
So first the Supreme Court judgment came, then the government is also passing an act on. I'm not aware of the name of that act.
Okay. No, actually there are two different things.
Okay.
They said that it is unconstitutional.
Yes.
Supreme Court has the law is that ordinance is
yes,
for criminalization of triple talaq.
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about this adultery controversy?
Yes,
what
sir.
Was it and what is what happened to that?
Yes, sir. So section 497 of IPC talks about adultery, where a husband can actually complain about the another man who has indulged into sexual activities with her wife. So in this, it was found that the crux of this section was that woman was considered as the property of the husband, and the woman does not have the right to complain in such a case against her husband. So in thus the adultery was abolished by the Supreme Court.
By the Supreme Court.
Yes,
it
was.
Yes. Yeah, it is no longer an offence.
Yes.
Okay, can
it's
you
a
tell
civil,
us?
Sorry, sir. It's a civil offence. It's no longer a criminal offence.
What is civil offence? When these are two. Diametrically opposite, civil and offence. What is civil offence? How is adultery a civil offence? No, tell us.
Sir, I would say Supreme Court said that adultery can be used as a ground for asking for a divorce.
Divorce, yes.
Yes, sir.
So, can you tell us what is the mechanism to protect human rights in this country?
Yes, sir. So, first I would say there are laws, there are institutions like district courts, high courts, Supreme Courts that are there. The second would be also the National Human Rights Commission, which takes such cases on a either suo motu basis or either when someone complains. The third would be the PIL, also is one of the bases on which human rights complaints can be put forward. The fourth, I think the parliament, the institution of democracy itself is there to protect our human rights.
Okay, one current, there was this thing in news,
yes, sir.
Supreme Court order on concerning human rights. Last few days, there was something in news. Can you recall that?
Sir, can I recall it for a few minutes?
Yes.
Few seconds. Sir, is it related to the encounters that is done by the...
No, actually, it's Section 30 of the Protection of Human Rights Act calls for a human rights court in every district, which has not been set up.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Well, we close your interview. I'll give you a little feedback. Is this your first attempt?
Sir, it's my second attempt, but the first interview.
Process. First thing I would like to say that you performed very well. You've been able to handle most of the questions nicely.
You,
so, which means you're well informed and you can approach a subject in an analytical manner. Your personality is good, your poise, you have poise, your language, everything is good. There's just one thing I'd like to suggest to you. When I asked you a question about why the civil service, so you went on a pretty long explanation.
Yes, sir.
And then when you were asked about meditation, then you said, and you were asked whether you have done it yourself or through with the help of some trainer.
Yes, sir.
So you said, no, there's a funny story.
Okay.
And you were cut short.
Okay.
This is an interview just about 25-30 minutes.
Yes, sir.
You cannot give stories or you cannot give a long explanation.
Okay, sir.
You must cut it out completely.
Okay.
Yeah? And so that is my advice to you, that you cannot, there is no scope for any long discursive explanation.
Sir.
Right?
Yes, definitely, sir.
So in civil service also, you best thing for you will be to say, that number one, it provides an excellent career, because these are the highest civil services.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, all of us are looking for a great career. And secondly, it provides a unique opportunity for public service.
Yes, sir.
All that background, etc. has no meaning.
Okay, sir. Can I note this down?
Yeah, please? Sure, you can. Again, the qualities. So you come straight to the leadership qualities. And then you were not able to explain what the leadership, you were focusing on consensus and grievance redressal and all. Now that's not the job of SP or a magistrate, district magistrate, you know.
Okay, sir.
They have been given powers to exercise those powers without worrying about consensus or anything.
Okay.
It is their job to, within the confines of law and within the confines of the rules, to achieve results.
Yes, sir.
So you can't go on looking for consensus. What is important is qualities are hard work,
yes,
competence, professional competence, honesty.
Okay, sir.
Adherence to rule of law.
Yes, sir.
And moral courage.
Yes, sir.
These are the quality. And a great quality of a leader is to set an example.
Yes, sir.
Then the question is, example of what? Example of these qualities. You should be honest to yourself, you should be hardworking.
Yes, sir.
You can't sit in your air-conditioned office and give orders. You must lead from the front.
Yes, sir.
That is a leadership quality. Then you were asked a number of questions about constitution questions. One is RTI.
Yes, sir.
CBI. CBI has been excluded from the purview of RTI.
Okay, sir.
And security organizations like IB, RAW,
yes,
USF. Even the most routine inquiry, they keep saying no.
Okay, sir.
You'll have to only agitate in the either in this commission or in the High Court level.
Okay, sir.
But they just say no. You ask for an inquiry which has no security angle, they'll say no.
Okay.
And they get away by saying it because they have been excluded.
Exactly. Yes.
But of course, nobody has challenged that so far, whether even the most fundamental, most innocuous query, they can refuse.
Yes, sir.
You know? But they keep refusing this.
Okay.
Then Lokpal is another important issue.
Yes, sir.
You will ask certain other important constitution matters, for instance, Sabarimala, you were asked?
Yes, sir.
No? Again?
Yes, sir.
Rights of women, and then fundamental duties, these are some constitution questions. Triple talaq, adultery, mechanism to protect human rights.
Yes.
These are all constitutional legal issues which are important. And then, since you are badminton, etc., you
yes,
have been asked questions which you will be asked.
Yes, sir.
You were asked certain questions on subsidy, fertilizer, DBT. It was attempted, but it has not worked so far.
Yes.
DBT?
Yes, sir.
Fertilizer through DBT has not worked.
Okay, sir.
Change in the role of IRS, direct and indirect, these are all connected with our economy.
Okay, sir.
Whether things have improved or not improved.
Yes, sir.
Then your hobbies, a research subject, etc., Swachh Bharat. As DM Barnala, what will you do? Now, you made a statement which is not very practical, and that is, I'll get more industries. As a DM, you have no authority or power to invite industries.
Yes.
You can at best tell them, but it is the government which decides which industries will be placed where. There has to be a, you know,
yes,
we are with all for it. After all, it's a policy decision, you can't do it.
Yes.
But for employment generation, you have schemes, government schemes, which you as a DM should implement.
Yes, sir.
What are those schemes? Any idea? Any scheme?
Sir, for example, Pradhan Mantri Employment Generation Scheme itself. So it
Manrega is there.
Yes, sir.
Manrega is there.
Yes, sir.
So those are the schemes. And you can also say, if there are vacancies in various departments, you can tell those department heads to fill those schemes. That also provides employment.
Yes.
Those are the ways in which you do. Then since you have done computer science, etc.,
yes,
therefore you will ask question about big data.
Yes.
You should be prepared to answer more questions like, what is digital India, how it is working,
yes,
what will be the benefits of this scheme. And so these are some of the important areas which we have asked you, and I would conclude by saying that there are two areas where you should focus. One is current affairs.
Yes, sir.
Second is on your biodata. You take a look at your DAF, and then most questions will be on that.
Yes,
and thirdly, on constitutional issues,
yes,
or issues relating to fundamental rights, fundamental duties, etc.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So
yes,
you're doing very well. Keep
thank
up
you,
your good work.
Thank you, sir.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Good
luck.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.